Hey guys, today I've got a ring compressor I want to show you. This is the piston and rod out of that 212 Ducar and rings. It's all brand new. I just disassembled it the other day for you guys. And this is a quick reminder, make sure you get your rods installed where the dipper goes down and your arrow on the piston pointing down. But this is no, I'm no stranger to these tapered compressors, but until recently, I didn't know they had made them for these small engines. And I'll put all these part numbers in the description. I used to use these on the small block Chevy engines and the small block Ford engines. And the tapered ring compressors are really the way to go. You just put a little oil inside, and I'm just using a little lightweight Marvel Mystery oil on here. Just to lubricate everything up. I don't want to scuff all this stuff up because, you know, I'm not going to be too concerned with ring placement, gap placement or anything, because I'm just going to install this and just pull it right back out. But you just start it in the big end of the taper, and you have a little skirt hanging out of the piston. So you can start it in the bore and just give her a push down, and that's it. That's really all it takes. You know, I think these cost around $30, and a lot of guys are probably thinking, hey, you probably didn't have any rings on that piston. Yeah, and these are the standard rings. These are not low tension rings either. These are stock tension rings, and they've got quite a bit of tension on them too. But you know, you just start it out, put it in the big end of the taper. I'm gonna make sure I smear this oil around a little bit. But put it in the big end of the taper. And of course, you want to stagger your rings if you're installing it in the engine. Just leave a little bit of the skirt hanging out. Make sure your arrow is down on the piston. Long end of the rod's pointed down too. Give her a start. Just push it in. That's it. It really is that easy. And, you know, it's around $30 for each. Or you can buy a whole set that has the different sizes, the 68 through 72 millimeter. And this is just the 70 here. And again, I'll put these numbers in the description. But if you're going to be fooling with these engines, guys, you really need to get these. This is well worth the money. You will save the cost of the part in broken rings. That's all I got for today, guys. Thanks for hanging out with me. We'll see you next time.